Knud Rasmussen. Knud Johan Victor Rasmussen, /RismSN/, June 7, 1879, December 21, 1933, was a Greenlandic Danish polar explorer and anthropologist. He has been called the father of Eskimology and was the first European to cross the Northwest Passage via dog sled. He remains well known in Greenland, Denmark and among Canadian Inuit. Early years. Rasmussen was born in Jakobshavn, Greenland, the son of a Danish missionary, the vicar Christian Rasmussen, and an Inuit Danish mother, Lovise Rasmussen, née Fleischer. He had two siblings. Rasmussen spent his early years in Greenland among the Kalaallit, where he learned to speak Kalaallisut, hunt, drive dog sleds and live in harsh Arctic conditions. My playmates were native Greenlanders. From the earliest boyhood I played and worked with the hunters, so even the hardships of the most strenuous sledge trips became pleasant routine for me. He was later educated in Linge, North Zealand, Denmark. Between 1898 and 1900 he pursued an unsuccessful career as an actor and opera singer. Career. He went on his first expedition in 1902 to 1904, known as the Danish Literary Expedition, with Jürgen Brønlund, Harald Moltke and Ludvig Mulius Eriksson, to examine Inuit culture. After returning home he went on a lecture circuit and wrote The People of the Polar North, 1908, a combination travel journal and scholarly account of Inuit folklore. In 1908, he married Dagmar Andersen. In 1910, Rasmussen and friend Peter Froyken established the Thule trading station at Cape York, Kanak, Greenland, as a trading base. The name Thule was chosen because it was the most northerly trading post in the world, literally the ultimate Thule. Thule trading station became the home base for a series of seven expeditions, known as the Thule expeditions, between 1912 and 1933. The first Thule expedition, 1912, Rasmussen and Froyken, aimed to test Robert Peary's claim that a channel divided Peary Land from Greenland. They proved this was not the case in a remarkable 1,000 kilometers, 620 miles, journey across the inland ice that almost killed them. Clements Markham, president of the Royal Geographical Society, called the journey the finest ever performed by dogs. Froyken wrote personal accounts of this journey, and others, in Vagrant Viking, 1953, and I Sailed with Rasmussen, 1958. The second Thule expedition, 1916-1918, was larger with a team of seven men, which set out to map a little-known area of Greenland's north coast. This journey was documented in Rasmussen's account Greenland by the Polar Sea, 1921. The trip was beset with two fatalities, the only in Rasmussen's career, namely Thorild Wolf and Hendrik Olsen. The third Thule expedition, 1919, was depoting for Roald Amundsen's Polar Drift in Mud. The fourth Thule expedition, 1919-1920, was in East Greenland where Rasmussen spent several months collecting ethnographic data near Angmagssalik. Rasmussen's greatest achievement was the massive fifth Thule expedition, 1921-1924, which was designed to attack the great primary problem of the origin of the Eskimo race. A 10-volume account, the fifth Thule expedition 1921-1924, 1946, of ethnographic, archaeological and biological data was collected, and many artifacts are still on display in museums in Denmark. The team of seven first went to eastern Arctic Canada where they began collecting specimens, taking interviews, including the shaman Aa, who told him of Uvavnuk, and excavating sites. Rasmussen left the team and traveled for 16 months with two Inuit hunters by dog sled across North America to Nome, Alaska. He tried to continue to Russia but his visa was refused. He was the first European to cross the Northwest Passage via dog sled. His journey is recounted in Across Arctic America, 1927, considered today a classic of polar expedition literature. This trip has also been called the Great Sled Journey and was dramatized in the Canadian film The Journals of Knud Rasmussen, 2006. For the next 7 years Rasmussen traveled between Greenland and Denmark giving lectures and writing. In 1931, he went on the sixth Thule expedition, designed to consolidate Denmark's claim on a portion of eastern Greenland that was contested by Norway. The seventh Thule expedition, 1933, was meant to continue the work of the sixth, but Rasmussen contracted pneumonia after an episode of food poisoning attributed to eating kiviak, dying a few weeks later in Copenhagen at the age of 54. Honors. In addition to several capes and glaciers, Knud Rasmussen Range in Greenland is named after him. He was awarded an honorary fellowship from the American Geographical Society in 1912, and its Daly Medal in 1924. The Royal Geographical Society awarded him their Founders Gold Medal in 1923 and the Royal Danish Geographical Society their Hans Egede Medal in 1924. He was made honorary doctor at the University of Copenhagen in 1924. Bibliography. Notes. Further reading. External links.